Hello, I'm Turul Jelmas from LSR Lab at EPFL Switzerland, and this is our work, FML Astroturfing Attack, the Case of Factory Trends. In this study, we introduce a novel attack, FML Astroturfing. The goal of the attack is to create a trend which is in line with traditional astroturfing, but in the FML astroturfing, the inauthentic actions are removed with no effect on the impact, meaning that the trending entity continues to be trending. We know this attack by observing the attacks targeting trending topics in Turkey. There has been a systematic manipulation of Twitter trends by bots. This problem is currently under rest. There was no prior study, but we know it because apart from our own observations, there were media reports, and Twitter took down some of the bots in 2020, claiming that they were involved in the information operations, and those bots were, some of them were trend creating bots, and they didn't fix the problem despite the fact that we disclosed the problem and our analysis twice. Now we introduced a new attack, FML astroturfing. The target of this attack is a voting-based system that further promotes popular content. Twitter trends is one example, and another example could be Instagram's explore section. Coordinated and inauthentic activity can manipulate this system and push the content they favor by making it seem popular to the system. In other words, there is somebody controlling multiple accounts, making them vote the same entity so that this entity will look popular to the system. The ephemerality plays a role if the actions or the votes of these inauthentic accounts are removed, but the impact continues because the system doesn't check if the popular content is still popular or the actions that made it popular are removed. We call this a time of check, time of use problem. As we stated before, this attack played a role in the case of fake Twitter trends. Twitter trends show what's popular now using the trending algorithm. The FML astroturfing attack is conducted by coordinated posting and deletion of tweets using bots. The tweets include some pre-made or generated tweets plus the target keyword. The trending algorithm infers that the keyword is trending because it's contained in many tweets, but doesn't check if these tweets were later deleted. Because the tweets that manipulate the trends are deleted, the attackers can use compromised accounts, and the owners of the accounts might not notice the inauthentic action taken in their behalf. Here we give examples of two attacks. The first one is Syrians Get Out. As you can see, there's a bulk of tweets mentioning the hashtag for the first time in the head of the plot. Then those tweets were deleted, but the hashtag was still on the trends list and it grabs attention of regular Twitter users. Then we have another example of a cafe advertisement. There are bulk of tweets getting posted and deleted in a second. Then the cafe advertises itself, and there are consecutive attacks to make it stay on the top of trends list, but there's not much of a genuine activity. We inspected the tweets getting posted by bots and deleted by those attacks. We found that they are posting tweets that pass spam filters of Twitter, but to an external observer, the tweets are obviously generated. They randomly pick words from a lexicon, and the words are infrequent and not repetitive. Since we didn't observe any other pattern, we used a rule-based classifier to detect such tweets and classify whether if a trend is fake or not. When we inspect the accounts posting such tweets and manipulate trending topics, we found that there are genuine users who actively use Twitter, but their accounts are used for trend manipulation in parallel. By personal interviews, they are either not aware of the problem, or they are aware but do not know how to fix it. We observed that there are phishing websites being advertised on top of the trends, such as gain free followers, or see who look at your profile in exchange for the login credentials. We signed up a Honeypot account to test whether these websites compromise the users and found that they do. Our Honeypot account participated in 560 attacks in 5 months. We believe that Twitter's trending algorithm impose a cult filter and might ignore the tweets of accounts that seem inauthentic. So these compromised users help creating fake trends because their votes are not ignored. To report the prevalence of fake trends, we need to classify whether a trend is fake or not. The challenge here is that we do not know what is trending before it becomes trending. And when we see a new trend on the trend list, the bots already delete their tweets. The solution is the 1% sample, 1% real-time sample provided by archive.org. In the sample, there are both the deleted tweets and also when the exact time they are deleted. We classify the generated tweets by a rule-based method and then classify if a trend is fake or not if they contain at least X generated tweets that are later deleted. We found X to be 4, but in the full sample, this could be as big as 400. After classifying all trends since 2013, we found that those attacks have begun in June 2015 and still ongoing. We found that between June 2019 and September 2019, they made up 47% of top 5 trends in Turkey and 20% of top 10 trends in the world in average. Our caveat is that we detect fake trends using 1% of all tweets. If we had access to 100%, we might have discovered more fake trends. We found 108,000 bots active between 2015 and 2019. 45% of them were suspended or deleted by now. 33,000 were still active in 2019, and there were 6 communities of bots in 2019, and 2 communities were already taken down in the same year. We found that some same community of bots promote different political parties, suggesting that the attackers made the fake trends a business model. We found over 6,000 fake trends in 2019. We categorized the trends. The biggest category is illicit advertisement. These include spam like phishing websites, fake Twitter trend service, and gambling. Political trends like political slogans and disinformation campaigns. Appeals to government asking for policy reforms, trends promoting religious cults, and other kinds of trends that can be anything, such as marriage proposals. There are several implications of the fake trends. First, it hides the reason why something is popular. There are some political science studies analyzing the hashtag Syrians get out, but they collected the data after the hashtag was trending, and thus after bots deleted their tweets. They failed to attribute the hashtag to the bots. And it poses a security problem for Twitter. First, the trending algorithm is compromised, and second, it creates a market for compromised accounts. There are also political consequences, as there are many trends, including disinformation and hate speech. As such, Twitter becomes a fake proxy for what the public speaks and what the politicians should listen to. This issue still hasn't been solved, but the study became transparent, so we hope that the issue will be fixed, and also the academy and the policymakers will learn from this attack. Thank you.